Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Hippocrates. I'm a natural philosopher from over 2,400 years ago, and I've studied the mechanisms of inheritance.
Okay, well, lay it on us.
It's called blended inheritance.
Well, what's blended inheritance?
Blended inheritance is the idea that one particular trait in an offspring came from one of the parents directly, or is a mix of the parents' traits.
But how do you think that works exactly?
I'm not exactly sure, but I've seen this fluid that comes from the male reproductive organ, and I think females probably have something similar. My theory is that it's a mix based on the battle fluids between the male and female.
Well, I'm pretty sure you're right about the male reproductive fluid.
But I think you're a little behind the times on the female fluid.
My theory is that these fluids are actually an amalgamation of fluids from throughout the whole body, each responsible for forming that particular part. The fluid from the toes is responsible for forming the toes, and the fluid from the eyes is responsible for forming more eyes, and so on. At conception, a battle of the fluid takes place, and the child will resemble aspects of whichever fluid wins that battle, one or the other parents, or a mix of both.
Okay, I mean, even though we know a lot more about how reproduction works now, your idea of blended inheritance does sound kind of reasonable.
But I can think of an example that breaks the rule of inheritance. Which of the following scenarios do you think shows that Hippocrates' blending model doesn't explain every trait?